Welcome to Electron Line. These two graphs here give you a striking comparison between the two major players in the atmosphere. We still haven't talked about what methane can do and what nitrous oxide can do and what oxygen 3 or what we call ozone can do in the atmosphere. They do play a relatively minor role, but these are the two big ones, carbon dioxide and water vapor. And when you set them side by side, you see some striking differences. We do have some very distinct bands that carbon dioxide can absorb, but we already realize that this particular band right here falls in the region of the Earth's radiation, where there's very little radiation being produced, and therefore there's not a lot being absorbed right here. And notice that the 2.7 micrometer radiation from radiation absorption from carbon dioxide falls square on top of a radiation band that water vapor already absorbs, so there's not a lot of contribution there as well. Basically, the only two that really matter is this big one right here and this one right here. Now, this one is relatively small, and it does absorb some of the radiation that comes from the sun because it falls in the 2 micrometer range, which is already part of the Earth's, what we call black body or the sun's black body radiation curve. But this is the big one right here. This is the one that absorbs the most radiation as far as carbon dioxide is concerned. But even then, there's a combination here where water vapor also, to a large extent, absorbs the same radiation. So combined between water vapor and carbon dioxide, this band here is completely already absorbed. So you can see that water vapor does a lot more than carbon dioxide as far as keeping the Earth warm, and it's a good thing, because if it wasn't for the water vapor, we can say here, without water vapor, the world would simply, not the word, but the world would be a frozen ball of ice. Simple as that. Carbon dioxide simply cannot do enough to keep us comfortably warm. It's a combination of both the carbon dioxide and the water vapor that does the job. And by far, water vapor does a bulk of the work, as you can see. It really absorbs a large amount of the atmosphere. Now, a good thing that it doesn't absorb everything, because if everything was blocked off and none of the radiation got back to space, it would get really, really hot here, and then we'd be on the other side of the problem where it would be much too hot. There's a window here where a lot of the radiation that is being sent off from the Earth's surface does escape to space, and that's called the atmospheric window, or we can simply call it the water vapor window. This is the portion of the radiation coming from the Earth, the infrared radiation, that does readily make it to space, especially in this band right here. Virtually all of it makes it to space, and here there's a partial absorption inside and a partial absorption on this side. So together, enough radiation gets to space to keep the Earth at a particular temperature that is fairly comfortable for us right now. So you can see, if you compare the two, definitely it's the water vapor that's the main reason why life on Earth is nice and comfortable, and the temperature is where it needs to be, where we can live in a comfortable manner. And there it is, a striking difference between the two.